Thank you for helping us reach the 50,000 subscriber milestone. This support and encouragement is what motivates me and my team to create more content every day. Today, we are going to talk about passwords. In fact, we are not going to talk about passwords at all. The topic is passwordless login. For decades, we have been using login ID and password, and that is no longer safe. If you just use password to login into anything, most probably you are already hacked. Your password is broken. Why am I so confident? Because it's very easy to break passwords. I just did this search 2 minutes back. Look at the results. 30 million ways of breaking passwords. It is giving you step-by-step instructions. There are videos as well. There are hardware devices which are very cheap. A child can learn all this and break passwords. What does that mean? We have to increase the level of protection by doing something other than passwords. We know that. You know, money is important to everyone. So banking transactions, you don't just use password. You get an OTP. Shopping transactions, you get OTP. All of us are happy with that. But even that is now hacked. Username plus OTP is also hackable. Now we have to go one step further. We have to generate the OTP, but the OTP should not come on SMS or phone call. Then who will generate the OTP? Oh, I install an app beforehand. That's called an authenticator app. There's Microsoft Authenticator, Google Authenticator, many different authenticators. You can use the ones which are relevant to your logins. So if you're using Office 365, obviously you should use Microsoft login. If you're using Google Workspace, you should use Google login. An authenticator app can be used for logging into multiple things. So I can use Microsoft Authenticator to log in into Google or Facebook or Amazon as well, and vice versa. Now that OTP will be generated by the authenticator. That's even safer. And that works even if you don't have mobile connection or internet connection, because that app is going to generate that OTP and it refreshes every 30 seconds. So again, someone looking at the current OTP is useless. All right. Now, in this case, what is happening? I am putting the username, I am putting the password, and I am putting the number generated on my mobile, right? It's still cumbersome. It's safe, but cumbersome. So can I make it convenient also and more safe? And the answer is yes. So instead of generating that number by the app on the mobile and then you typing it, there is a simpler version called phone sign-in. Microsoft Authenticator supports that. So once you enable phone sign-in, you just put username. It does not ask you password. It'll show you 2 digits. You just type the digits on mobile and you're logged in. The password doesn't come into picture. It's so simple. And because it's simple, you don't need to remember your password. That means you don't need to change your password, and all the problems associated with passwords are gone. So that's how you should enable passwordless. Now on Windows PC, what do? Again, we use password? Dangerous. There are multiple ways of eliminating password while logging into Windows. The safest is face sign-in. So I look at the screen, it recognizes me, logs in. Nothing to type. In order for this to work, what do you need? Oh, you need Windows Hello compliant camera on the PC or webcam on the laptop. Now, these are not just webcams. These are webcam with another camera, which is infrared camera. So combination is used to authenticate you. And what is the benefit of that? It's almost impossible to fool it. So I am sitting, it'll recognize me. If the light is low, it'll still recognize me. If I put my photo, it'll not recognize it. If my twin comes, it'll not recognize it. If I create a wax statue of mine with beautifully done makeup, it will still not recognize it, because infrared takes up heat also. So there are multiple patterns which are used to match. That's why it is almost foolproof. Now every laptop and every PC may not have such cameras. No problem. Nothing to feel bad about. We have PIN. PIN is just 4 digits, 4 or 6, you decide. And that PIN, 4-digit PIN, is better than this long, complex, scary looking password. Do you know why? Because the password may look complex, but once the password is known, that password can be used in many places. That's the problem. Password travels over the internet, so anybody can hack it through Wi-Fi, through internet somewhere. Whereas the PIN, this is the PIN I use every day. I am showing it to you publicly. Is it not dangerous? No. PIN is safer because if you want to misuse my PIN, you'll have to come to my house, you'll have to sit on my PC, and then only it'll work. So PIN is only going to work on that device. So if you have two laptops, each will have separate PIN and they will not work with each other. And please don't put same PIN for both machines. That's a bad idea. Anyway, so almost all PCs and laptops allow you to have PINs. So that's how Windows login becomes passwordless. Browser login becomes passwordless. So any login, make it passwordless. That's the idea. If you are from IT, make sure all your users have passwordless logins. If you have Microsoft 365, it's built in. It's a part of Azure AD or Entra. No extra expenses involved. The only thing you have to do is convince all users to install Microsoft Authenticator app and enable that phone sign-in. It takes 2 minutes. It's not technically difficult. Practically difficult because people will resist. And in order to make sure people don't resist, IT cannot go to thousands of people and convince them. The best way is to make your bosses see this video. They will definitely get convinced. Then you install it for them. Then they will say, oh, this is so much easier for me and it is increasing security. Productivity increase, security increase. Great, let's do it for everyone. So now bosses will help you in doing this for the entire organization. All this sounds great, but think of the practical stuff. Suppose I lost my mobile phone. How will I use the Authenticator app? How will I log in? Good question. So whenever you are setting up multi-factor, you should set up two factors for regular thing and the third factor, one more factor for emergencies like this. So you can have one-time passwords. That's another option. Or you can have a safety email ID, which is only used for getting a recovery password. So that's how use two factors for regular authentication and have a backup authentication method for emergencies. But wait. It may not be possible to eliminate all passwords and convert everything to passwordless. You will still need to manage some passwords. Now there, don't put passwords in a file and put a password to it. That can be hacked in seconds. Use a password manager. I already have a video on how to use a password manager. Have a look at that. I'm sure you found this useful. Use it immediately and like, share, subscribe, comment so that YouTube also knows this video is useful and it'll show it to many more people, making their lives more secure. So that's it for now. Thank you. See you next time.